Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. In last few days, I was researching about a new few things in PowerPoint, and that is experimenting with more add-ins. So let's get started, and today we are going to talk about Script Lab add-in that is developed by Microsoft. Install the add-in by clicking the add-ins button from the Home tab, and you might find the add-ins option in the insert tab if you are using any other version. I am using Microsoft Office 365, and you can check the version by clicking on the file tab, file menu, and then click on the accounts link, and here you can find that which version of PowerPoint or Microsoft Office you are using. I am using Microsoft 365. From the home tab, I will click on the add-ins button, and here you can see we have the script lab, or you can click on more add-ins, and let me uninstall the script lab first by clicking on my add-ins, then click on the three drop down button and choose remove. That way you can uninstall any of the add-ins that you have previously installed. And I have also shown you the functionality of web viewer, that how you can embed a live web page into your PowerPoint slides. You can go and watch that video. I have given the link in the cards and in video description. So let's move back, and again I click on the add-ins, click more add-ins, and here I will search for Script Lab. You can find it right here in the left side pan, right side pan, and here I will click on the add button and will click continue. So as soon as the Script Lab add-in get installed, you will see a new task pane on the right side. So that is what we are going to learn and talk about, that what are the Office add-ins. So let's move to the home page of Script Lab and see what it really is. So Script Lab is a Office add-in, and if you don't know about Office add-in, that is what I am going to teach you about. This is our first tutorial on Office add-ins, and Script Lab is one of the Office add-ins created by Microsoft to teach you that what you can do with the Office add-ins and how you can develop your own PowerPoint or Microsoft Office add-ins. You can also develop add-ins for Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook. So let's first see how Script Lab works. So I move back to PowerPoint, and as soon as the Script Lab get installed, you will see this sample section here, and you can find a lot of samples here. So basically what these samples do, you can use Script Lab to interact with your application. So here is an example. Let's say if I want to insert an SVG image, then I click on this code here, and it will get loaded into the script section. You will see the JavaScript, and in the HTML section you will see the relevant HTML and CSS codes and the linked libraries. So now if you want to test your own codes, and if you are interested in coding JavaScript, coding HTML and CSS, if you are already doing this, then you can go and run this pan here, and the selected sample will run. So you can see that we have this task pane here, where we have now a button, insert new SVG, and now as soon as I click on this button, a new SVG image is get inserted on your slide as an object. So let's move back and here, and let's explore what Script Lab can actually do for you. So experiment with Office JavaScript API without ever leaving Excel, Word, or PowerPoint. So I will show you a few examples here, just like I have shown you this one. So create and edit code snippets that can include JavaScript, HTML, CSS, as I have shown you that. You can create your own snippet by clicking on this three line burger button, and from here you can click on new, and you can here start writing your own codes. So same they have described here. So if you move down, and here you can find this video that how Script Lab works. So here is an introduction. So you basically write the code into the snippets, and as you run the code, you can see that it has inserted a hello world text box on the Excel worksheet. So it is showing you that you can also run that in Excel. Let me show you by clicking on start. Let me open Microsoft Excel, and you will also find the script lab under the add-in section. So here we have the script lab in Excel, and here you can find chart data table, create bubble chart. These are the examples, create charts. Let's say I run this one, create charts, and run the code, create table. You can see that instantly it has created a table which has been predefined in the codes here. So same example has been shown in this preview video. You can see that how the code has been written, and running the code immediately create the objects on the worksheets, documents, and on the presentation. You can also create solutions for the Microsoft Outlook as well. So let's explore more about Script Lab. And this was just a basic example. So if you are interested creating in Microsoft PowerPoint or Microsoft Office add-ins, then you can learn more about Office add-ins platform. So I have given the links of these documentations in the video description. You can go and learn more about how to develop your own Microsoft Office add-ins. I will publish more tutorials on this topic. This is the first one where I am just showing you an example of Script Lab add-in, which is specifically created for showing you the power of Office add-ins. So if you Google and search for Office add-ins platform overview, then you can read more about how you can create your own Office add-ins. There are different development platforms and different type of add-ins that you can make, and you can find more detailed information on these documentations. I would also like to tell you that you also need to look into the Microsoft Office object library. You can see that. So here I had created a video about how you can use the VBA codes to create new macros and to automate tasks. And for that, we need to use the Microsoft Office object library, and you can automate all of these tasks of a particular application of Microsoft Office like PowerPoint. So you can see here we have the object model, and if you click on the overview, then you can read that what the object model are and how they can be used through the coding. So either you can use them through VBA coding, or you can use the new Office add-in platform. And here you can use HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to automate the task or create new functionalities or new functions that can create new things which are previously not available in Microsoft Office. So in my next tutorial, I will show you that how you can set up your own development environment to create your own Microsoft Office add-ins. And I will tell you two types of development that you can set up. And I will also explain you that what type of add-ins you can create. Either you can create web add-ins, or you can use Visto add-ins, that is Visual Studio tools for Office. I will explain all about these topics in my next tutorials. And I hope I will come up with a new solution, like when we run this SVG code here and insert the SVG, then it gets inserted as a object, as a XML SVG object. and you see a new graphics format tab on the top. So you can develop new solutions for Microsoft Office application, either for PowerPoint, Word, or Excel. Like you can create your own ribbon items like this graphics format, or you can also create a new object model like using languages like C# or .NET framework, or you can also use JavaScript, HTML, and CSS to develop your own add-ins. So let me load one more sample here, and that is insert shape, line, and text boxes. And upon running this snippet, you can find certain operations that you can accomplish right from this Office web add-in. So like you can create shape, shrink shape, move shape, you can create line, a text box, play with all kind of objects that are available in VBA model. However, I want to show you the capability of this web add-in task pane. So, like what it is capable of doing inside itself, not outside itself, like not on the slide, but inside this web-in task pane. And for that, we move back to the codepen.io website. And here we have this animation, EverVault hover effect. And we have another animation here, canvas magic mouse effect, and the Nixie tube clock. You can see this shining clock. So I copied and pasted these codes into the new snippets and saved those snippets like this tube clock, and I run this tube clock snippet, and you can see exactly the same animation right in this task pane. So that is how powerful this task pane is to render all the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript codes right into this task pane and show you the output. So as I said earlier, you cannot just merely create a button right here, and clicking that button will run an event handler and will insert that picture or animation into the slide. That is not quite possible, because Microsoft Office JavaScript API and Power JavaScript API has certain limitations, like you can only work with VBA model. So I have saved two more animations that I would like to show you. And another animation is this EverVault hover effect. Let me run this. However, this is not this animation is loading properly. But the last one, which is this one, magic mouse effect. Only this animation has not loaded properly. So, but still you can see that how powerful the task pane itself is. So you can use Node.js or Visual Studio. If you want to use Node.js, then you have to use Yeoman Generator to develop your own Microsoft Office add-ins. Or if you want to use Visual Studio, then you also have to install Office SharePoint framework along with that. The libraries that are required to create PowerPoint add-ins and to generate new add-in templates inside Visual Studio. So I will explain about all these topics in my next videos, and I hope you will find this tutorial useful. I will advise you to try the Script Lab add-in and test how these example works and how you can interact with the Office application using these add-ins. So that way you will get a few new ideas that what you can do with JavaScript, or you can use you can create VSTO, that is Visual Studio tools for Office application. You can also create those kind of add-ins, and those add-ins require C#, and with C# you can use .NET framework. So I will explain more about them in my next tutorials, and I hope you will like this one.